What's happening, forum? You know what's funnier than an Asian kid struggling with math? An Asian kid struggling with YouTube. What's up, fellow gamers? Today I wanted to do some sort of an update. And YouTube has been the only place where I myself has created a strong bond with. And I really do appreciate people actually supporting and watching the videos. And it means so much. It really means so much to me. Yeah, this much. This much. I started this channel in 2017, and I only saw myself doing outside videos, more of on the vlogging side, because when I was younger, that's what I did, doing the fucking weird vlogs, and most of the kids are weirded out because they don't know what vlogging is, and I would just like whip my camera out, pointed directly at me, and people would be like, what the fuck is this kid doing? Over the years, I became much more comfortable with the indoor setup videos, where I just sit down, talk, and react or play games, which I like the most because I was able to explore more of myself. There's just so much comfort with this setup for some reason. I felt more free, if that makes sense. And most of the fun that I have making videos is just this setup, this whole room setup, because it's really simple. It's just a table in the corner on the fucking wall. That's just it. So basically this table, I record videos here, I write some stuff. Edit, and this is the only place where I can be as loud as I can, but not too loud because the cop's a neighbor. So, but it's not like it came to a point where I got complaints from the neighbor, so I think it's all good. I don't think it's appropriate for me to say fuck the police because guy's a good cop, come on. And soon enough, this whole room setup will be gone forever, sadly. The details I want to keep disclosed, apparently it will happen sometime in the future. It's kind of bittersweet because I grew up here and some of the earlier videos that I did started in this room. And I literally have no idea where I'm going to shoot videos next or record videos. Not until I find a decent spot, which right now doesn't exist. So possibly I might go on a break, but I don't see myself doing that because I just love making videos so much. Or maybe outdoor videos in the meantime, who knows? We'll see. We'll see. Some of you may or may not know, I work in the hospitality industry, mainly as a server or a bartender, which I kind of wanted to talk more in a different video, but I just wanted to say that I feel like over the past few years, I feel like I've done so much in that area. Especially when I was in Nashville. I spent about a year in Nashville working as a server. And when I got back in the Philippines after a year, I worked as a bartender. And after a few months, I quit it because it was just a fucking shit show. It was a terrible fucking place. And yeah, several months later after I quit it, the pandemic happened. And 2 years later, just about a week ago, I got another job. I got this new job offer at a fine dining here in Manila. And I felt really good. I felt alive during my first day of work. Kind of feels like I was revisiting like my first experiences working as a bar or as a server. Feels like now is just a good time to finally close that book. I just feel like that's all I can give as a server or a bartender. Like one last ride working at a fine dining restaurant. I have no idea too what else is gonna happen next, but that's the fun part. And at the same time, there's just a strong passion in me that wants to focus more on making videos. So,
you know what? I'm not leaving. I'm not leaving. I'm not fucking leaving! That's just it. Just wanted to get a little personal. So, yeah, soon enough. Goodbye setup. Thank you so much. Also, goodbye hospitality industry. Thank you. What about you guys? How are you? Ooh, actually, I posted a story.
Do we have any questions? We got, what are you doing, step bro?
What are you doing, step bro?
Is it not that obvious? Whipping my... No. Don't do that.
Stop.
I've been reading a lot on philosophy lately, and there's this one great philosopher that once said, tell your mind to shut the fuck up. Shower then eat, or eat then shower. Eat then shower. Because sometimes food fragrance can stick to your skin. So yeah, food, eat first and then shower. Do you eat balut? Yes. Yes, I used to, not anymore, just because I wanted to eat healthier stuff. Can you imitate Cookie's bark? Aw, I would do that, but Cookie is sleeping. I literally woke him up for this video.
You sleepy?
Is it okay if I imitate your bark? Yeah, not in the mood. Sorry.
Yeah.
Sorry, I woke you up. Yeah, that's the best that I can do. Have you ever done skinny dipping? No. Are you happy? Tough question. I'm never happy. I mean, not happy, but I'm content. Do you believe in love? Yes, I do believe in love, and the best way to show that is by liking this video and subscribing to the channel. Thank you. Body count. What the fuck do you mean by body count? Like, does it look like I killed enough people? What the fuck is that question? All right, tell us something you've never told anybody. Something I've never told anybody. Something I never told anybody. When I was young, there's this neighbor's kid that was a girl that had a crush on me and left me a love letter at our garden. It was just a cute little story from when I was young. How is your day? My day is okay. Thank you for asking. That's a wonderful question. I like that, by the way. Is that your dog? Yes, that is my dog. Kaninong aso si Bullet, or who owns Bullet? Bullet was our family dog and is resting peacefully in dog heaven now. He was 10? I'm assuming 10. Yeah, he was 10 years old. Bakit ka puro Skyrim, or why do you always play Skyrim? Because I love it. Got a handful of questions. Thank you for asking and participating. That's just it for today's video. Hope you enjoyed. Until then, I'll see you in the next video. Hey.